Okay.
Wow. We got QuickTime?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You got to explain it in the game.
All right, well, we got a sub. You subbing for Billy? So he's going to be drinking for you.
He's going to drink for you.
Okay.
You got a designated hitter.
Oh, shit.
All right, we're going to give you two choices. This is a game we play here. It's a drinking game. Okay. We'll give you two choices, and you pick one, and nobody drinks. But if you say both or neither. So basically, if you don't answer the question, we drink it.
Got you. I'm going to have you dudes fucked up. Ask me all the questions.
We drinking with you. We drinking.
Yeah, I got you.
God damn, y'all niggas ain't going to. Oh, hell no. Yeah, thank you, bro.
Ready?
I know what y'all niggas be up to, bro, but I ain't falling for that shit, nigga.
No, this is the game we celebrating.
I want you, my nigga, but I'm watching you. I know you off the show.
Hey, hold up. And before we start, because people think it's a setup on dissing somebody, it's not a diss.
No, I'm only trying to say the name.
We want people to be mentioned. Like, this is about talking about.
I talk a bunch of shit. Don't pay me no mind.
Nas or Kiss?
Oh, shit. Both.
So we drink
it. I gotta take a shot too.
I mean, we drink it with you.
Okay.
You can sip it like that.
You can sip it like that if you want. Okay.
This is where we get fucked up.
That nigga crying up here and shit. Oh, hell no, nigga.
It's happened.
Nigga, don't catch me, motherfucker.
ODB or Bismarcky?
Wow.
Damn, why are you doing that, Paul?
Yeah. You crazy? And I've seen this before. I've seen you do this before.
And if y'all got stories, like, add on to it. Put a story with
it. But you made it a little lighter for everybody else that was here. Why are you doing this to God?
He wrote this
question. This is your man.
Hey, yo.
They said both?
Yeah, they said both.
Yeah.
You
I got a drink?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, Lay's got me.
All day.
All right, cool.
This is so you could answer the question, though.
Yeah, yeah.
And any stories you guys...
You going to do that?
I got this.
It's a good one.
But it's impossible fucking answers.
Some of them are.
Jay-Z or Big Daddy Kane?
You gonna...
I love them both.
I grew up Big Daddy Kane, bro. Okay. I would go.
Kane is my era.
Right.
You know what I mean? Jay is my era too, but right. Kane is, you know, before that. So okay. I'm going to say Kane.
Yeah, we'll say Kane.
Rockefeller or G-Unit?
You a cold nigga, bro. No, you cold.
I'm just reading.
Where did you read that? That's a good one.
Now, I'm going to say... I'll say G Unit. Because of their run, like, right? Like as and not just because we was out with them, like we did business with them, but it was like almost everything was in line. You know what I mean? Everything that I mean, starting with 50, right? Like first record with the most amazing fucking one of the most amazing hip hop records ever made. Cannot front on Get Rich or Die Trying.
No.
That whole album was a motherfucker.
Mm-hmm. I mean, a fucking
that whole
beast.
album.
And then he brought everybody else into it like he was supposed to. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And they all did well. Not saying everybody at Rockefeller didn't do well, but they all platinum, multi-platinum, everybody.
Right.
And their whole shit, it was well put together. You know what I'm saying? But shout out to Rockefeller because, you know, Dame is my guy.
Right.
Fuck with Jay. I love fucking Beanie and, you know, that whole state.
Right.
Probably crew, but I think G Unit kind of got him on that. And when the G Unit record was coming out, I guess I could tell this. When the G Unit record was coming out, and Jay said it himself, how he kind of everybody was kind of scrambling at Rockefeller, like them niggas is coming. Mm-hmm. So you know what I'm saying? Right. Do something. And I think there was a Rockefeller record that came out around the same time. So they was kind of competing for the space for that first week sales, and I think G-Unit beat them out. So, yeah.
You know what's crazy? Did you guys realize, because you've been on several situations, labels.
He said, have you realized it?
No.
We were there.
Not that part. But the fact that you had all those opportunities where people kept wanting you, how revered you were by not just the culture, even the industry, the folks that were in the industry side of it.
It's the respect.
They revered you guys to keep bringing you into these places. That's it. I just thought about it right now.
Yeah, no, we appreciate it, man. I think it took me after I stopped you know, hitting so hard to actually realize
to realize that.
You know what I'm saying? Most of the labels, with exception of the first Select Records, right? Mm-hmm. Everybody else was a fan. Wow. It took, yeah, everybody, 50 will tell you that, Jay will tell you that, Steve Rifkin. Jay and Dame used to come, when we were working on the second album that we put on Relativity, Jay and Dame used to come and try to get us to be a part of Rockefeller. This is when the Rock was a pebble, right? There was nobody there. They had an office probably this size, right? There was a young lady at the front desk. It was just Jay and Dame.
Wow.
Right, and they would always try to. I never met Biggs at the time, though. I just remember Jay and Dame, and they would show up to Gabriella's studio. We were working on 26th Street. They would show up every other day. Mm-hmm. They'll come rock with us. Come rock with us. We didn't. You know what I mean? At the time, we went
Relativity. Yeah.
Which we were supposed to go to Loud then, but we went to Relativity.
And Beatin' Us was at Relativity at that time?
Yep.
Beatin' Us as well, yep.
Okay.
3-6 was over there, too.
Yep. Yeah, 3-6.
Yeah, 3-6, yeah, it was dope.
Bone Thugs.
Relativity had a lot.
Yeah, Relativity had it popping.
I think even Joe was over there.
Yep, Joe was over there. Jealous 1 NV came out over there, yep.
I remember.
Yep.
Tila.
They denied me at Relativity.
They won't fuck with you.
They won't fuck with me.
They missed out, right?
Good. They missed out. It's their loss, bro. That's it.
Premier or Pete Rock?
Jesus Christ.
Take a shot. Salute.
I love both of them, nigga.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is the hardest shit.
Nah, this is gonna be.
I grew up on both of them, bro.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Oh, you want to explain that?
Huh?
You want to explain?
I grew up on both of them, man. Right. I love them niggas, man.
Right.
Motherfucking Pete Rock, that fucking, that boy was on fire.
Yeah.
Fire. Nobody, like this nigga remixes. Fucking that nobody. Fucking shut him down. Hold it now.
Yo, everything.
The Run DMC joint.
Everything. Down with the King. Everything was crazy.
Fucking Brand Nubian. Fucking Pete Rock, CL Smooth. That boy was.
And CL Smooth. I don't know what rumor it is. It's like someone spread a rumor that CL Smooth wasn't welcome on Drink Chance. That's not the truth.
No, that's not true at all.
Yeah, he's definitely welcome.
Nah, CL, that nigga,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah,
yep, definitely.
P Rock, shout out to P Rock and CL Smooth.
Shout out to P Rock.
Shout out to DJ Premier, shout too. Demo, my brother.
Yeah.
That's my nigga. Premier is one of my favorites in the world,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah, mine too.
Yeah,
both of them.
He's one of my favorites in the world.
Nah, I love him. I'll be a little not mad at him, but there's some things I wanted to get off my chest at times.
With who?
With Premier. Like, there's certain beats that certain people have that I go, God damn,
that's
I wish
that.
God damn.
Why you get that shit to us?
Why you get us? We want everything you make, nigga. That's it.
He doesn't make duds.
But no, he don't. What he does, though, is he makes, he's not like a lot of other producers. They just got a computer
bunch of
full
beats.
Of shit.
Right. Yeah.
When you come to the studio, he make the beat.
He caters it. Yep.
Yeah.
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 It's almost like how we make Quick Time with Slime. Like, you know how like Haz and Mr. Lee kind of like listen to like the first five questions and then they come up with the questions. It's the same thing. Like Premier, to me, like we would have conversations and he would make the beat based on our conversation.
Yeah.
Like he'll be like, yo, and then just start making a beat.
Yeah.
Then dead that beat and just talk to me again.
He was like, that's not it.
Yeah. I was like, this is a genius shit. But I was just mad that he kept throwing the beats away. That's how talented he is. He'll just make another one.
Yep.
Or got this.
All right, this is gonna be a tough one. Guru or Big L?
Oh, hell no.
Rest
in peace to both.
You niggas gonna need new livers in this motherfucker.
We probably already did.
Both,
okay.
Both. So what?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Come on, man. Join us. Salute.
My shot.
And by the way, listen, rest in peace to them both, though.
Yes.
You can do light shots. We're doing light shots.
Rest in peace.
Shots.
Okay.
Good excuse.
Light
shot.
This one is going to be real, too. Big Pun or DMX?
Rest in peace to both.
I'm going to just take the shot.
Wow. That's cold.
I love them both, bro. All
right, so I'm going to be taking a shot.
Pun is my motherfucking heart, bro.
Right. Yeah.
Pun is my brother, bro. So, I sat in the studio with Pun, like, we was doing that, the New York Giants.
Yeah.
Bro, we, for like a week, we used to go up there. Never got nothing done. Never got no work
because
done.
Because of this shit.
Nah, this nigga would sit around and just joke and joke and joke. And we... we just hanging out, basically. This nigga burning money in the fucking studio. Right. You know what I mean? He got his family there and shit. This nigga just, Pun is one of the funniest niggas.
So you picking Pun?
No. I love you, Pun.
In this like case, it's hard to pick.
Yeah, both.
If you go for lyrics, I ain't even fuck with that
any interaction with X?
Both.
I love DMX. X. Yeah, I love X too.
Yeah.
I ain't get to that.
X.
Salute. Both. Let's drink.
X had me. I remember first, like, actually hanging out with. Well, when I first met him, we was doing.
I love the Apollo X too, together. But everybody know.
We did the Apollo together, and
wow, what year was that? Do you know?
I was drunk. Nigga, how the fuck I don't remember. But this is when he first came out. When he was first coming out, right? This is MOP. That we not cocky, right? But. You know our work. We know we get busy or whatever. We meet him. He like, "Hey, what's up? You know, good to meet you, whatever." Boom. All right, cool. This nigga gets on the stage by himself and fucking destroyed the Apollo. I'm never really nervous and shit. That's when we made it snow in the Apollo. But he get on the stage by himself and destroyed the Apollo. Mm-hmm. Then the next time I saw him that time, and obviously we'll pass each other and kick it, whatever. Then some years later, I saw him in Germany.
Austria.
We toured with him a couple.
Yeah.
Actually, the last fight we just did in Germany, he was there with us. But he not stole the car, but he had got the car. And he going, "Yo, come on. Get in the car." I'm not getting in that motherfucking car now, because the story just happened like 3 weeks ago, how you was in a fucking car and talking about you was the FBI and all this old shit. I'm like, I'm not getting in that fucking car with you. You gonna get on the Autobahn at 200 miles an hour and shit. You drunk, I'm drunk. Nah, bro, this shit ain't gonna work. So I had to decline.
You must have been not, you weren't that drunk.
No, I wasn't that drunk.
I wanna say X is a good dude. X is solid dude. Same person every time.
Yep.
Every time we seen each other, same nigga.
Right.
You know what I mean? So shout out to DMX, man. He's the honest dude too. The nigga's so fucking honest.
To be honest, like, every record he made, I didn't like every record, right? To be honest.
He was dope, right?
But I was more of a Earl Simmons fan, right?
Man, like
I'm the person. This nigga felt so familiar. I don't give a fuck what kind of records you make, how big they are, but if it's like it's you, like I can, you know what I mean, zone in on you, like
that's
I can tell who you are.
To the fans. Right.
That's why I love that nigga.
Right.
That's why I love him.
D&D or Quad Studios?
D&D.
Damn, that was fast.
Yeah.
Mobb Deep or Smith & Wesson?
Oh, go on and drink.
Why you ain't drinking, nigga? How you
I'm drinking. Look,
good audible.
That's crazy.
I love them both, bro. Mm.
You know, Mobb Deep is the first artist that we started dealing with in the industry.
Really?
The first.
Dealing with how?
Like just ran into and we kind of got cool with.
Mm.
The very first for me. The very first.
I love Mobb. I love Smith & Wesson. Shout out to Smokey.
Yeah. Them dudes are dope. Yeah, by the way, just so you know, Prodigy was supposed to be on Annie F Remix.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. But obviously Prodigy, rest in peace to Prodigy, but obviously Prodigy being Prodigy, he started taking shots at.
Oh.
Yeah, he was taking shots at Jay. That's when they was going through their.
I did
hear about this record. I didn't use it, right?
Yeah. Now, we didn't use it because, I mean, you know, if y'all got y'all little, whatever issue
don't
y'all
put me
got.
Involved.
Yeah, don't put me involved. Yeah. And that's with anything, whether it's some music shit, some street shit, anything. Like, it's, you know what I mean? It's my house. Don't come shooting at a nigga out my window.
Yeah,
nigga, what are you doing?
You shooting at him. It's y'all beef, but you shooting at him out my car.
Out of my, like, come on. And I'm good with him too. Right. So.
Just and those are the days when you had to go to mix. So you knew you had enough time to think about this when you're mixing this record. Like, he's kind of going at him.
Like, what are you doing? What are you doing? Yeah, he was going at him. Yeah, he was at him. He was at him.
Okay.
Tupac or Eazy-E?
Wow.
Rest in peace, Tupac. I love Eazy, motherfucker E.
Yeah.
Rest in peace to both of them.
Yeah.
But Eazy, motherfucker E.
Yeah.
I'm going
for it. I mean, Easy because of what he did, right? For
I grew up on Easy E, man. Coast, what do you want, bro?
West Coast hip hop.
Right. I mean, his tree is crazy.
Yeah, you can't. You can't.
It even goes to Tupac. His tree even goes to Tupac. Ooh,
yeah.
Easy's, if you think about it, to a degree, because of Death Row, that tree goes there.
Yeah. And Pac, just the passion.
Pac is a passion. See, I can't even compare them.
Right.
But if I had to choose one, I'm going to pick Easy E. You know what I mean?
Love. Right. Yeah. Pac would say Easy.
That nigga's just tired.
That's the way I always think about it. Pac would say
just tired of drinking.
I say they drink more.
I say I drink water.
So you saying both?
I'll say both.
Yeah.
I'll say both. Yeah. I was just trying to give an explanation, nigga. You wouldn't let me get an explanation.
I forgot I could have said both.
Okay, I got the next
one. We got a drink. He said both.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll go with that.
EPMD or MOP?
Bang!
Yeah, MOP, but that's
shout out to EPMD.
All of these questions is hard, man. Kind of birthed MOP, right? Like, we got it from them.
Right.
You know what I mean? But I got to go with the home team, right? Yeah, I love EPMD, but got to go with the home
team. Would y'all do versus against EPMD?
I wouldn't do versus.
Bust their ass.
You wouldn't do versus?
I wouldn't do versus.
Why?
I wouldn't do it.
Like, now speaking about EPMD, why would you do versus?
This nigga's interviewing me. Why the hell is he interviewing me?
It's open interview.
But no, the reason why I don't like, and shout out to Swiss and Tim. I feel like somebody got to come out on the bottom, right? Somebody
like
someone
loses that.
Someone loses and they potentially lose what they built for so many years.
You but not I mean? Red and Meth kind of celebrated each other. They
yeah,
was against
each
other.
Yeah, but that's Red and Meth. Right. You know what I'm saying?
But who do you think lost in that way that you're thinking? Because I think everybody's kind of won. They reminded the fans of their legacy.
So I'm not a good gambler, right?
Right.
I'm not really willing.
Gambling.
No, I'm not willing to put up something that I built for 30 years just for that hour, right? And people go, yo, it's for the love of hip-hop, it's for the culture.
But
bro, I'm not losing what the fuck. I got fucking kids and grandkids and shit. Them motherfuckers need to eat later on down the pipe. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to fuck up what I got just for that moment.
For that moment.
Because, I totally understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
And I think that the only people who kind of made it like that is the New Yorkers.
Possibly.
Like, everybody else was kind of celebrating each other.
Yeah.
I believe... In particular, it was Dipset,
and very in particular that situation.
Yes, I mean, and they turned it into
that was a good versus. Though.
It was a great versus,
but they still both won in a way.
To me, I say that
how?
Dipset went on tour after that.
Yep,
and I don't see anybody dragging Dipset's name through the mud after it. Really,
how about Gucci Mane and Jeezy? Whoa.
So, I think that one was almost a little dangerous.
Yeah, I didn't feel safe watching it.
I think that one was a little
3-6
dangerous.
Well,
3-6
and
oh, I forgot.
And both dangerous.
But that was from the beginning. And I remember them. I ain't gonna lie to you. I remember them having beef on tour.
From the
beginning,
sideways.
I was like, this is not gonna work.
Right.
That shit went sideways.
So, but you wouldn't do it?
No, I wouldn't do it. I wouldn't be comfortable with doing it.
Mm.
Be for that reason.
That's fucked up. So now we ain't doing the verses.
You just find this out, man.
You just said we ain't doing the verses.
I said I'm not doing it.
You just said we ain't doing the verses.
We ain't doing the verses. I just don't like the feel of it. You know what I'm saying? I think that everybody works.
You could have
so
pulled me to the side and said that. I think that.
Drink champ. Drink champ.
Let's make some noise. Let's make some noise. DMX still in the car and I'm not doing verses. Oh my god, this is great.
Illmatic or Ready to Die?
Mm-mm.
Well, I mean, we'll go back to it.
I just drink, bro.
Okay. Just drink? All right, let's go.
No, I just did.
Okay.
that's what we do, though.
Okay, don't worry, bro. We celebrate.
Drink champs.
Illmatic or Ready to Die?
He said both, basically.
Oh, both? Okay, all right.
Without saying it, but he said it.
I've been taking my shots like Genuine now. That's how Genuine took his shots.
What the fuck was that?
Yo, remember he was taking a shot and then taking a sip of Coca-Cola on the side. Ooh, DR period or Lazy Lays?
Oh, man.
Don't look to the side.
Lays is dope. Lays is dope. All right, if we're talking about production.
I'm giving you DR.
Yeah, I'm about to say the same thing. Lays is dope. It's just DR.
He gave it to DR.
DR is the perfect well-rounded
production. He's the best drum program.
Right. Like, he can do
hip-hop. You getting technical with it now.
Yeah.
hey, we back in the studio with DR right now.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. We working on an MOP album. That shit coming out quick. We just started.
Independent?
Yeah. Huh?
We ain't get to that yet, nigga. We just in the studio. What the fuck
are
you talking about? We just got
in
the studio, nigga.
Shout out to my man Carlos Maldonado. Always big up DR period.
Yeah,
always
DR period's dope.
When I was in jail, he always
used to touch. I'll fuck everybody else's ass, though.
J. Rude the Damager or Master Ace?
Wow. You wouldn't ask these kind of questions if the camera was off with you.
Yeah.
No, you wouldn't. Yeah. No, you wouldn't. Y'all some cold dudes. J-Rue was dope. That's my bro. That's my guy. But I mean, since a kid, I was a Master Ace fan.
That's
right?
What Method Man said.
Yeah. Since a kid.
You know Master Ace from Brownfield?
No, I knew he was from Brownfield. Brooklyn. I didn't know what it was.
A nigga from Howard. Even Brownfield. Howard Houses.
Yeah. From Brownfield.
Okay. Yeah. Shout out to J-Rue. Shout out to Master Ace.
Shout out to J-Rue. He's in Germany, I believe.
So you picking Master Ace?
Yeah, Master Ace.
You picking Master Ace. Brownsville, you can't go there.
Yeah.
Okay, I respect it. Who'd you rap or Rakim?
That was a high school. That was junior high school argument. Yeah. High school argument, nigga.
Cup, nigga.
I don't know, huh? Yeah, I know.
Right, what you gonna do?
Yeah.
There's no, you gotta say both.
Junior high school, bro.
I can't help.
Junior high school, we used to fucking go back and forth. This day is fucking G. This day is Ra.
Yeah,
bro. We never got the answer to that one, bro.
So taking a shot today.
Yeah, I'm taking a shot at that one.
Salud.
And yeah. I wanna say, though, y'all go ahead and take y'all shot, man. I wanna say that Rakim, to me, Rakim is the best rapper ever. Right. I don't think we'll never find another one. Right. That's not, I'm not without the comparison to him and G-Rap, right?
Right.
Rakim is the greatest rapper ever.
Mm-hmm.
That's my opinion. And if anybody else have another opinion.
He doesn't curse and it feels like he's cursing.
Yeah, well, I love them both, bro. For different reasons, bro.
Yeah, me too. For different reasons.
And they both my favorites.
Yeah.
Both of them. Nah, equally.
And they super legends,
yeah.
Both of them.
Yeah.
Cube or Scarface?
That's the same shit.
With Biggie Smalls. Bring back your argument. Stupid.
That's the same shit, bro.
What's wrong with you, bro?
Yeah, that's your man who writes these questions. That's your man.
I love both of them.
Yeah.
That's you taking a shot?
Damn, bro.
Both?
Motherfucker.
No, yeah. Face.
I'm going for both.
How could you?
I love them both, bro.
I mean, Face. Nah. Face is my number two, right? For me, it's Rakim, then it's Scarface.
Face is an ill list.
Hey, let me tell you, that motherfucking Scarface album, motherfucking The Diary.
Oh yeah.
Oh no,
bro, that shit got me through so much shit.
Yeah.
Right.
You know what I mean? We used to steal tapes from each other. You hop in a nigga car, you forget your tape and shit.
Right.
You know your tape popped, your tape twisted at a certain point. Like, you hear next time, nigga, that's my fucking tape. We done stole that Scarface album CDs from each other so many times. That shit done passed around a circle.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So that's Scarface, Animal. That fucking The Diary, Untouchable.
Yeah.
Scarface is just a bad motherfucker.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then Ice Cube is a bad motherfucker. That nigga. So I just drank to it, nigga.
Right. I drank to it.
Yeah, everything it did from early on, Ice Cube is crazy. But then Scarface,
his argument.
It was an argument, man.
It was an argument, brother.
It was Scarface and who else?
No. I'm gonna
Scarface.
No. Yayo asked me who my favorite artist was. Right. I've always been a Cube fan since right. NWA. Cube, so I said Cube. He yeah. said Biggie. I said cool. And then he didn't like the. He went back. He's like, oh, and then he started arguing about it.
I would have won with Cube over Biggie.
Y'all
too.
Both arguing.
And then it became a career. To me, it became a career thing. Unfortunately, Biggie didn't have the career. Unfortunately.
Right.
Of course, Biggie. Come on. It's undeniable what Biggie. Yeah. But Cube had the career. Cube, NWA lineage. Like, you can't argue that, man.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
This is like a real hip hop.
I'm sorry to keep saying both. Yeah. But it's the truth, bro. How the fuck you can't? Yeah. I can't pick Ice Cube over Scarface,
right.
or Scarface over Ice Cube.
Right.
Yeah, you can't. You just can't.
That's real. Can you pick Kid Capri over Funk Master Flex?
I'm running with Kid.
Kid Capri. I'll do Kid.
Kid Capri is a bad motherfucker.
Kid Capri, another super legend.
I like, not to take anything from Flex.
Yeah, that's just my opinion.
Yeah, but
both are legends.
Flex is, I think Flex is the best radio DJ that ever happened, and I think Kid Capri is one of the best. Club DJ.
Club party.
That ever happened. Like, it's no party like a Kid Capri party. But when Flex got a good record, he makes me like it.
Yeah, right.
Like,
he's driving into your head.
Oh, yeah.
But the way he...
The bombs and bringing it back.
New York City pulled over. I pulled over. I'm like, oh, shit. I was like, all right, what the fuck? Yeah. What I'm about to hear? One time, I swear to God, I missed my flight.
It's true.
Because...
You told you pull over?
No, the Meek Mill. No, the Meek Mill, Drake.
No, but that one time you did pull over.
Yeah, I swear to God. I pulled over. I'd be hyped. Right. I'd be like, then he said, yo, go in there, go to the store and grab some cash. I said, hold up, let's maybe stop, Flex. Right. He's telling niggas to go on in the New York City.
And
put your hands in the cash register. I said, you going to get somebody killed. You know what I mean? But yeah, I love that shit. All right, let's move on. Okay, boom.
Oh yeah.
Black Moon or Onyx?
I say Black Moon.
Brooklyn. Yeah, Brooklyn niggas is loyal.
But not just because of the style of music for me, right? Like, I like their style of music. Okay. I love Onyx.
But Brooklyn is loyal. We've had Brooklyn catch it. We say it and they just say Brooklyn. Yeah. They won't even answer the question.
Yeah.
Brooklyn. Whatever. I guess we know what you're saying.
Right. So respect to Brooklyn.
Yeah.
Oh, definitely.
Okay. Thank you.
Fab or Pusha T?
Wow.
Fab.
I say Pusha.
They both nice to the motherfucker.
Yeah, they both dope. Yeah. But I say Pusha.
Okay.
I feel like that's kind of like both.
Yeah.
No. Relax, Mr. Lee. You're not even drinking. All right. MC Light or Queen Latifah?
Wow. Get your cups. Go and get your cups ready.
Solid.
Y'all niggas, bro.
You can't shit on Queen Latifah.
You can't shit on neither of them.
Neither one of them. So it's damn.
Life. Both?
Both.
Both. Come on.
I gotta say both.
And we need both on drink chance, please.
Yeah.
Y'all some motherfuckers.
I'm painfully hurt by right now.
Yeah, we talking about Queen Latifah, though, bro. We talking about MC Light. MC Light got the most.
I bought MC Light record, nigga, when I was a kid, nigga.
Which one?
I still on, huh?
Which one?
10% Dish.
I still don't think
I remember, huh?
You and I T.Y.
No, that's Queen Latifah, though.
I'm
saying both records.
But hot damn, homie.
We go again. Like, this is a rap. Yeah, that was crazy.
What? You don't want the beat? Oh, you having fun now, being all
the
oil.
I was a B-girl. Like, she was hell, man.
I don't think it's been a female with that, like, her voice.
Talking about
her voice, MC Light. Her voice is so fucking crazy. I don't think I've heard a female.
And her swag. The way she spit, she looks the same right now.
Dope.
She does.
Looks amazing. She looks amazing. Yep.
And she's doing all the voiceovers for everything.
That paper thin was, you know.
Oh, God.
Come on, nigga.
I want to see.
I told you I'm a nerd when it comes to this shit, bro. Yeah. I'm a fucking
paper thin is hands down one of the best records ever.
Yeah. Yeah.
I want them to do verses.
10%
kiss. Oh, yeah.
Pop Smoke or Nipsey Hussle?
I know a little more about Nipsey, like music wise. Mm-hmm. So I gotta say,
rest in peace to both of them.
Rest in peace to both of them.
I'm gonna take a shot for that.
And we're talking about.
I'll take a shot. I'll take a shot.
I
got you.
Salute.
Rest in peace. Both gone.
OC or Chubb Rock?
I love you, OC. Chubb Rock.
1990.
OC, Chubb Rock, I love you, bro.
The scene with a green, with a pocket full of green.
Come yeah, on, come on, yeah.
I grew up on that. We can't shit on OC, though.
We can't shit on OC. Big OC. Yes.
No, OC. OC.
Wow.
OC. If my memory is correct, OC is the first person we
asked. But OC is say Chubb Rock.
No, but, yeah. but yeah. OC is the first on, person we asked to be on the
You can't
MOP
even match
record.
That, though.
Really?
You yeah. can't match. That's two right. different eras, though, really.
Right.
It is. But no, I'm not telling you what to do.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah,
but that's two different eras.
Yeah.
So salute OC. I love you, brother.
Yeah.
Did, so
but
did
Chubb
you,
Rock was that
y'all
shit.
Y'all did
nigga.
The record with OC?
Yeah. What was the name of the record we did with OC?
I forgot, but it was on the first Family
for
Life album.
On the first Family for Life album. But that's the first, if I remember correctly, is the first artist that we asked to get on a record. To get
that's
on
dope.
OP record.
That's dope.
OC is fire, bro.
Yes, come on.
Yes, yes.
Fire.
Oh, shit. Hell yeah.
Low-key
does
something on
the low.
Yeah.
Method yeah. Man or Red Man?
I swear to God, I thought in my head yesterday, I'm standing in front of my fucking house. I said, watch these niggas ask that question. I swear to you. I said, watch they ask that
That's
question.
That's the obvious. You have to take a drink.
I don't drink
yeah.
before, man.
You drink yeah. Both.
Both.
I'm drinking.
Both.
Both.
Dan is loose with it, though, because he's not drinking. Both.
Thank you, brother.
RZA or DJ Muggs?
I say RZA.
Okay.
I say RZA.
RZA?
I say RZA.
Have y'all worked with Muggs?
No, I would like to, though.
It's crazy
no, yeah.
on a Muggs record. That,
yeah, I would like yeah. to, though.
But he's dope.
Muggs bad as a Muggs.
Oh.
He's very dope.
Yo, MTV Raps or Video Music Box?
Video Music Box.
Yeah, I knew y'all was going to say that. yeah, I knew y'all was going to say that.
Right.
Sean Price or Prodigy?
Man, you skipped.
Look, I just took a shot, bro.
I wanted that question.
Both.
Yeah, both. Rest in peace. Rest in peace.
Rest in peace, Sean Price. Rest in peace, Prodigy.
The Tunnel or Latin Quarters?
The Tunnel. Latin Quarters was a shit, but we weren't there.
All
right,
right.
We weren't there.
I ain't making Latin Quarters. Yeah, the Tunnel.
The Tunnel.
Lace at LQ, Latin Quarters.
So you gotta take a.
Nigga, I ain't never been there, nigga. The Tunnel. I know.
All right, Busta or Eminem?
Oh, hell no. What the fuck y'all doing, bro?
This is your man.
Yeah. But when
we giving
when
you
we,
your flowers.
When we. I mean, if we talk about careers, right? Like.
Both, bro. Bro. Both.
Yeah, I mean,
both,
it's,
bro.
Okay, it's both are amazing.
Like, what the fuck?
But Busta, I think, song choices, right? Like the songs that Busta made.
Right.
Eminem made some big, powerful shit, but I don't know if his catalog is rounded, as well rounded as Busta shit is. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But we say both. You niggas okay, want to keep Busta. Drinking? Go ahead. You know, I'm like a bartender, nigga. I sit back and pour it and watch you niggas walk out of here sideways.
And psychoanalyze it.
Young M.A. or Scarlett?
Young M.A.
Young M.A.
Young M.A.
Lost Boys or Naughty by Nature?
You come with the right, you go with the right fucking two that you, it's hard to pick, bro.
That's crazy, yo. That is crazy. Well.
I'm going with Naughty.
Yeah, I'll go with Naughty.
I'll go with Naughty.
But Cheeks is my bro. But that's my dude. You know what I'm saying? My dude.
When I
still
answer
hang
these
with
questions,
Cheeks now that you don't drink?
Say it again?
You still hang with Cheeks now that you don't drink?
Nah, I don't think nobody really want to stick with me no more, man. Niggas don't want to stick with me no more because I'm all sober and shit.
Right,
I'm a square. Oh, you go.
Kink's balls. He's a long drinker.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Like he starts out small, and then he starts speaking Queensanese.
Yo, bro, let me
like Queensanese.
So I know Queens really well.
Right.
I had Cheeks meet me in a spot in his neighborhood that he didn't know about. This is my drinking days.
Right.
Little Hole on Rockaway Boulevard.
Wow.
Dude, we drank so motherfucking much. I don't remember the spot closing.
Right.
I just remember being somewhere else.
Right.
Right. I know we got in the car. I'm not sure who was driving, which way we went. We went somewhere else, started drinking more. Even out here, years ago and shit.
Yeah, because he used to live out here. He used to live by my way.
Yeah, out here, me and him, I mean, dude, we walk up and down the strip one time and just like fucking animals.
Right.
So, but no, he don't really stick with me no more. Yeah. Shit, because I don't drink, but that's my guy.
He a good dude, though.
That's my guy. I love him.
He starts speaking Queensanese.
Queensanese.
I'm like, huh? Wait a minute. I don't even know that word.
Shout out Naughty by Nature, man.
Yeah. Shout out Naughty by Nature as well. This is one of my favorite questions. Wu-Tang Clan or N.W.A.?
Wow.
Let
me just say, man. I'm going to say Wu-Tang. See, I got different things in my head of why I'm choosing who I'm choosing.
You want to tell us?
I mean, I'm going to say... I'm gonna say Wu-Tang because
Walter Cronkite came out.
They're still.
Excuse me, sir. Would you like to expand on that?
I'm into this shit. I'm sorry.
I say Wu because they still a unit,
right?
After all of this time,
right.
And all of this success,
right?
Unfortunately, with N.W.A., we saw the breakup.
Right.
Oh, okay, that's a good point.
Early on, too.
That's why. Yeah.
Point.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. So Wu-Tang.
That's a good.
Analog or digital?
Analog.
Analog. All right, let's make me some noise because I'm an analog.
You're analog for different reasons.
I'm analog because, like he said, we made the record together. Look how good that record sounded. That record sounded like we made it yesterday.
Yeah.
Like, when I was just listening to it, because I haven't heard it in these many years, even when I was listening to y'all for a whole week, knowing that I had y'all coming up,
right.
I didn't listen to that record. I was listening to that record just now.
Right.
And when I heard it just now, I couldn't tell if we made it yesterday.
Yeah, right.
That's because we was in the studio together.
Right. That's what analog is about, is the being personally together. Where if you talk to the people with the equipment, they're like the analog equipment.
I want an analog record.
I want a digital mix with analog. He don't want to wait for the analog shit.
Listen, let me tell you something. That was the good thing. I was coming from being 5%er, so I would never go to the studio without knowing my rhymes right here.
Right.
I had never, during the analog days, I had never wrote in the studio.
Right.
I had always had that shit in my motherfucking brain.
Right.
So I didn't play no times. I would go in there and record.
Right. Yep.
Well,
right.
Some people use the digital shit, but it's just, they don't do no work.
Right.
They don't put no time into their shit.
Right.
So they just, yeah.
Because it's disposable. They can just keep doing it.
But I think the digital is good. I love the analog. Digital is good for artists like you.
Right.
Artists like us.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
For you could just punch in. You ain't got to rewind.
Yeah.
Right. You know what I mean? Your tape pop off and all that shit.
Yeah. You know what I mean?
They don't know that pain. I think the digital would have came in handy for those times.
Right.
But besides that, analog. Hell yeah.
And I always give that to Traj, man. I know I'd probably never said that. Traj would make sure, like, yo, we're going to do 3 records. Make sure you got all your rhymes. And I would... For a week straight before I went to the studio,
right.
I would have the rhymes in there. So when that's why if you listen to the War Report, I'm always the first one on the motherfucking record.
Right.
It's because I had my shit ready. I was like,
my nigga, I ain't gonna lie to you.
I'm going.
That album is
fire.
One of my fucking
favorite.
I still listen to the album, nigga.
Yes. Good looking.
Yeah,
bro.
That's my shit.
We give you this. Yo, it's your
thing. I got you.
Okay. All Eyes on Me or Life After Death? That's Tupac and Biggie's out.
Wow.
I'm actually going to go to Life After Death.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm going to go with that one, man.
I go with All Eyes on Me.
Wow. All right, so we're not drinking.
Yeah. I'm trying to save you, niggas.
Yeah. Good looking.
No, but the truth is, like, two different kind of artists to me.
Yeah.
Right? And for me, I like the passion that Tupac had.
I can respect that.
You know what I'm saying? So that's why
you ever got to meet Tupac?
I was drunk, bro, so I don't really remember. But for what
you probably met mad people. You
met mad people. Dude, I got a picture on
thank you, bro.
Yeah, I did. I know I did. But I met him with Biggie, but I can't remember.
You met Pac with Big?
Yeah.
You got to remember this, man.
I can't, bro. What do you want me to do?
No. That's a memory you need to keep, man.
Who the hell just says that? I met him. He said it so nonchalant. Yeah, I met Pac.
Because, I mean, everybody like, knows they were good. They were friends at one time.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I never met Pac at all. Yeah. But that's how I met him. But being, you know, drunk as fuck. But I always get, you know, slack for people ask me about in comparison to Biggie and Pac.
Right.
I love Big. I love him as an artist. I think that lyrically this nigga was nuts.
Right.
But I lean more towards Pac's passion.
Right.
You know what I mean? So
they're two different artists, bro.
Yeah, two different artists.
What? I told you. I'm going with Big. Life after death.
Okay, that's right.
Yeah.
That's right. He said that. Radio or podcast?
Podcast. Radio ain't got fucking play that. No, wait. How you gonna ask a nigga that never got no radio play, radio podcast?
Man, has these.
Right.
Has Mr. Lee making these questions?
New Jack.
We gotta talk after this shit. Damn, you line me up, Has.
Yeah, bro.
New Jack City or King of New York? Movies.
New Jack City or King of New York?
King of New York, yeah.
King of New York. I go King of New York.
Okay.
New Jack City.
Y'all doing this on purpose now.
No, we're trying to save you niggas.
Nah, that's cool. I got two shots. I'm going to take them anyway at some point.
Tony Yayo or Lloyd Banks?
Going Queens against Queens.
Fuck y'all niggas, bro. I don't know, bro. I got a drink. I'm a drink, bro. They're my homeboys, man. I got a drink.
Yeah.
We're going. My homeboy.
And this is the only one to me.
That's not a trick question.
It's not a trick question, but kind of a trick question. It's the only one that I always feel like you should say both.
Okay.
I mean, you can't say that and then ask
my bad.
The question.
My bad.
That's some crazy shit.
Loyalty or respect?
I mean, really? Loyalty.
Loyalty is everything.
But with loyalty gonna come to respect anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
If you're loyal to somebody, you're loyal to them. You're loyal
to different answers,
their feelings. You're loyal to who they are. You know what I'm saying? You're loyal to that person. So you would respect somebody that you're loyal to. Am I right or wrong?
Yep.
I mean, it's really an individual's perspective.
In case you ain't know, this nigga's a Harvard student. How the fuck he got all good answers?
I would say the easy way out is just say both. Give me both of that shit. Loyalty and respect.
Is all that is. Right? But if somebody respect you, that don't mean they're gonna be loyal to you.
Right?
Because if a nigga respects you, that could mean he even fears you in your face.
Right.
But a nigga may do some underhanded shit that you can't see. But if a nigga's loyal to you, he's not doing anything underhanded. Am I right?
Right.
But if you get the option, as we're given, loyalty or respect, and you could have both, I'm taking both.
Right.
Give me both.
But you got both with one if you pick the right one.
Right.
I'm smart, bro. I'm sharp, champ.
You taking a shot for that?
I pick one.
Okay, all right.
Fuck out of here, bro. Get off me, you know?
We'll drink to that.
This answer was so great. That's the reason why. Oh, man. All right.